Okay, so stay up on your feet and you can stay loose. Okay, E equals MC squared, basically just stating everything in Kata has to work with physics. And that's just as John Doe first done. What that means is it doesn't always translate to a grading. So some things I'll talk about today won't affect whether you grade or not, and they won't affect, you know, your tournament score if you're thinking of tournaments. So sometimes there's certain things in Kata where it's like, oh, you've got to do it this way to grade, or you've got to do it this way, otherwise you might get marked down in a tournament. Other things don't apply to that. Certain times, you know, you can't see what someone's feeling inside, and so it's not going to help them in a tournament, it's not going to help them at a grading. So just understand that not everything has to equal that, but E equals MC squared with a tick. Basically, you want to make sure everything has a tick with physics. Is anyone here a physics professor or has a degree in physics? No, okay, that's a problem. If we can all come back here in 6 years and you all have a degree behind you. You don't need to have a physics degree to understand how something works with physics. So is anyone here an expert in boxing? Okay. So then you're the only one who can't answer this question. So can someone tell me if this is a bad boxing punch? I know you can tell me. Is that a bad boxing punch? Why? Why is that a bad boxing punch? Oh, okay, let's pretend I was really strong because I'm broken at the moment. Why is it a bad boxing punch?
Shoulders and hips are rotating opposite directions.
Exactly. So you don't have to have a physics degree or you don't have to be an expert in boxing to understand that from a physics perspective, that makes no sense if my goal is to generate as much power and speed as I can. If my goal is to ultimately be effective, look where my body weight's going and look where my arm is going. So you don't have to be a boxer. Like, I'm not an expert in boxing, but if I saw a boxer doing that, I could instantly say, that's bad. Agreed?
Hey.
Okay. So sometimes in karate, we do things, and someone who doesn't even know karate, or maybe not even know physics, but they might look at that and just go, that doesn't make any sense. What that is doing doesn't make any sense. And that shouldn't be the case. Everything we do should be able to hold up. So that if we had a physics professor come in here today, you know, an engineer or something like that, and just say, can you please just stand here, and we're going to show you how to do every move in every kata, they should just, on every move, go, yep, 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 yep. And if there's any move where they go, nope, then we should eliminate that. But that doesn't always translate to gradings, by the way. So, can I borrow Tony for a moment? That's it. Can you just grab this move in MP here, and then come up, and then next move, boom. Okay, so see how he's punched almost straight? Okay, versus down. So he's punched almost straight, but where was his energy going? Where was his weight going?
Down.
And where was his punch going?
Down. Forward.
Forward. So does that make sense from physics? If you want to punch somebody that way, why would you send your energy in a different direction? You follow? That makes no sense, right? Oh, because karate tells me to do it. Well, karate should shut up, and karate's not telling me to do that, because karate says I'm trying to forge you into a weapon. I'm trying to make you the most effective weapon you can be. So if you want to punch, if you want to send your body down, it should be because you're punching
down.
So when we do it in MP, I pretend I'm in a low stance, I want to be punching down, so it makes sense.
I'm this way.
So that, in other words, now it makes sense. Do you follow? I'm sending my energy in the direction of the punch. I'm sending my energy in the direction of a punch. That's how karate should operate. So we'll do some drills on that as we go through. But what happens is in every move, in every kata you ever do, you've almost got to think, does this make sense from physics? Some people do lunge punches and they finish like this. That makes no sense. Versus working with the lunge punch. Or they punch and they finish like back here. Like, see how my shoulders are behind my hips? And it's like, oh, because I'm meant to be upright. But are you meant to be sending your energy that way or you're trying to punch that way? No. So this is where you can self-correct. This is about teaching someone a fish versus giving them a fish. So I could teach you a kata, Goju Shiho Sho. Yeah, that's the name of a kata. And you'd be able to go, oh, this technique should be a little bit like that, or this technique should be a little bit like that, just on your own understanding of basic physics.
You mentioned punches, but the same is relevant for blocks as well, isn't it?
It's everything. Yeah. Everything. Punch, block, kick, grapple, everything is about working with physics. Okay, so the first drill we're going to do One syllable technique, you should have a tick. In other words, a one syllable technique should be a one syllable technique. So everyone make a punch. Hey, Kudach.
Hey.
Okay, and itch. That's one syllable. We don't do this. Correct?
Hey.
Pa, unch, pa, unch. It's just punch. It's one syllable. Hey. Obviously, syllable is to do with grammar and not to do with karate movement, but it just makes sense. So one syllable technique. Okay, make a head level block. Okay, you ready? Itch. That's one syllable, right?
Hey.
We don't go, see how that's it? Sensei. Sensei. Block. Uke. We're not doing it in two syllables, we're doing one syllable.
Hey.
Get an uke. Itch.
Hey.
Knee. How many people go one, two? One, two, rather than one. It's a one syllable technique. Hey?
Hey.
So in kata, when a technique is a one syllable technique, make sure it's a one syllable technique.
Hey.
And what we're going to practice now is that. So original lines, go. So there are a number of times in kata where we have a one syllable technique, like you said, in punching. So we want to make sure it stays and remains a one syllable technique. It's very common for people to move through and they release the pressure here. So they kind of go one, two, one, two. Or they'll do this, one, two, one, two. You've made it a two syllable technique. Or in first kata, they'll do this. One, two. One, two. It's not just a one syllable technique.
Hey.
Kankurai, they'll go one, two. Oh. Or Senpai, they'll be one, two. It's, you're creating an extra movement in something which is slowing you down.
Hey.
Stepping forward, punching you in your face. You ready?
Hey.
Punch over your front knee. Over your front knee. That's it. Itch! Knee! Rip! Okay, going backwards. Aruke.
Hey.
Itch. Knee. Sun. She. Go. Okay, we're going forward strong now. Stepping forwards with a punch. Remember, while you're moving through with your legs, the entire upper body does not move at all. It remains still. And at the last moment, it replaces itself. We don't relinquish pressure and then punch. We don't relinquish and then punch.
Hey.
When we're going backwards, we don't stop and go. Stop and go. When we create a two-syllable technique there, we've lost all our momentum. Now, if you're Arnold Schwarzenegger, that's great. But if you were someone like yourself, blocking me, who's much bigger than you, and your momentum started from here, it's not going to work. You want to take every advantage you've got to build momentum. So we make sure it's one syllable. Stepping forward. And fast now. Itch. Backwards head level block. Itch. Hold that position until it's time to go. Check it out. Go left foot forward, sun chin dutch, mate. This is the technique in senpai. So you're going to maigiri, turn, go back into your short punch. Bring your pace, hitch. One, two. And then up again, mate. Knee. One, two. That's it. And up again, hitch. So again, keep it one syllable. Up, see this? Movement. Movement and then kick. No good. If it's kankurai, movement, kick, no good. If it's kankurai here, for example, stop, go. That's two syllables. Why would you want to start a kick from here? You've lost all your momentum when you could start it from the ground and go bang. More momentum. So if it's one syllable, make it one syllable. One syllable. If it's a front kick, make it a one syllable technique. And